Hey, what's up, guys? Jeremy here from RoboDK. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can define the position of the TCP or tool center point of your tool with respect to the robot flange of the robot. This is the first step in order to be able to calibrate your virtual station so that it matches with the actual real station you have in front of you. So to do the TCP calibration, different methods are available on the market, but we'll start with the standard one, the four or more points method. To do that, it's pretty simple. You just need to have a little tool like this one, so I call this one my TCP definition tool. It's just a small aluminum rod that I CNC machined, and it has a small, let's say, pointy stick here. I also have in my plate some threaded holes that I can use to simply screw in my TCP definition tool. So the goal of this tool here is simple. It will give us a XYZ position that won't move throughout the calibration. So the only thing we really need is a position in space that won't change for the next few minutes that we need it. The method itself is pretty simple. I'm going to take the robot, match as precisely as possible the pointy stick of my TCP with the pointy stick of my TCP definition tool. I'm going to record that position. Then I'm going to move the robot to another orientation, but same XYZ position. This is why I need this reference here. I'm going to record that point. I'm going to do that for at least 4 points. I highly recommend using 6 to 8 points if possible, because 4 is not that much. One detail that I really need to tell you with this specific robot, you need to do the TCP calibration using pretty much the same configuration as you will use for the pad. So if, for example, for your pad, you need to have the wrist over the forearm, you need to do your TCP calibration with the wrist over the forearm. Don't rotate joint 4 to have the wrist underneath it, or you'll have some calibration error, or you won't be as precise, if I can say. So first thing to do is go to RoboDK and take a look at the method that is available for us. Inside RoboDK, I already created a RDK tool 60 deg or 60 degrees with values that are completely arbitrary. So I decided to put those values at 0, minus 109 and 163.5. Those match well with the 3D model that I have here, but the 3D model I have here do not necessarily represent the reality because, as you can see here, I have an aluminum core, a hole, and a stainless steel rod with just 2 set screws. So it's impossible to know exactly the position of this rod here. So we'll use the four or more point method to define where it is. First step to do is go to utilities and then define tool frame or TCP. You will have a small image showing you pretty much the setup that I just showed you in real life here. And then you can decide how many points you want to use. So in this case, I'll go for 6 points. Okay, so it will add more points to the points that we can fill here. We can simply bring the robot to a certain position, go on the robot controller, grab the position one by one, and copy them here manually. But that would take a bit of time. As we've seen in a previous video, we are able to connect to the actual robot and retrieve the position of the joints or the position of the TCP. So we'll use this method here to go a bit faster. To show you that this method gives you the exact same result as the method proposed in the robot controller, we are going to do both methods at the same time with the exact same points. So I'll switch from TMflow and RoboDK every time I get a position. So if we go to TMflow and I go to menu and then settings, I can go to TCP settings. And here we have get parameters of TCP from teaching. So in other words, this is the four or more points method. By default, it has 4 points. So let's go for 6 point here so that we match what we have in RoboDK. First thing, if we click on next here, it will ask us to move the robot to the first position. We'll do that. So I'll start by moving the robot as close as I can using free drive. And then I'll ask my colleague here to actually move the robot so that those fit as close as it gets from one another. Can you go down in Z 0.5, please? Give me 0.1 in Z. Again, one last time. Okay, Z seems perfect. I was kind of lucky in terms of Y and X, I feel like. So this is, I would say, very, very good. If I go back to TMflow, I can simply click record. It's gonna ask me to move the robot and record another pose, so I can click OK. Then I'll go back to RoboDK. Now I need to connect to the robot real quick. So right-click the robot, connect to robot. As I don't have any listen node running on the controller, I can just click connect. I will have the connection problem, but this is not a big deal. We just want to be able to retrieve the position. And I can click command. And I can get flange position XYZ. Now, if I just move the tool definition window away for a second, you can see that the robot position pretty much match the one that we have in real life, and this is what we are expecting here. Inside the tool definition, you can see we have a small, first of all, we have select tool at the top. You need to select the tool that you want to define. In this case, is the RDK tool 60 degrees. If you go down, you have calibrate using joints. Because TM do not use the nominal kinematic that we have in RoboDK, we, as for now, we are forced to use the pause option. It's not a big deal, it's just a different method, but it will work as well anyway. So now I can go command. Okay, I can go command again just to make sure that I have the right position. So yeah, flange position, click OK. That didn't move, perfect. Now I can click get P1. As you can see, it automatically populated the values from the robot controller. So 631, 208, and 347, and the rotation. So this is cool. So now I can go back on the robot, rotate the tool, and try to match it again. And then I'm going to ask my colleague to go down in Z, at least 3 millimeters. Again. Okay, X plus 2 time. Okay, 1 millimeter up again in Z plus. Okay, 1 millimeter in X plus. Okay, and you can go down in Z at least 2 millimeters. Okay, X minus 0.1. Okay, so that's it for the second point. Back to RoboDK, I can click get command. Okay, yeah, here I can just go and record this point already. Perfect. And then I can go to RoboDK and command, get flange position, click OK, and then get P2. Boom, perfect. So then I need to do that for the other 4 points. So I'm gonna fast forward this part of the video. In this case here, we can click on update. Current value, yeah, cool. We just need to replace. We can, as you can see in your station tree now, you have a small target on the TCP here that is appearing. That means that the calibration is done. And now the new position, as you can see on the top right corner of the of RoboDK is 0.663 minus 109.93, sorry, and 163.65, sorry, 0.45. If I go to TM, TM asked us to give a name to this TCP, so I'm gonna call it TM Calibration, TM Cal 60 Deg. Okay, save and apply. And as you can see here, the values are 0.67 minus 109.95 and 163.65.43. So it's pretty much the same exact values as we had with RoboDK. Okay, so now that our TCP calibration is done, we need to make sure that it's actually accurate. So we know that the TCP calibration we did with the controller and the one we did with RoboDK does match in terms of the actual value we got. But now we need to make sure that those values are accurate. So to do that, I just asked my colleague to move the TCP a bit up. So we're just like 0.5 millimeters or a bit more away from this point here so that we don't, let's say, hit it when we rotate. And the goal is to rotate that tool around either X, Y, and Z. In fact, we will rotate around the three parameters to make sure that our TCP calibration is accurate. And if the TCP here does not move with respect to our, let's say, reference here that is static, that means that the TCP calibration is good. If it moves, we pretty much need to just redo the whole calibration again. So can you rotate around? So here, rotation. It's kind of static. Okay, can you rotate in another direction, please? As you can see, the TCP is pretty static with respect to our reference here. Nothing moves except the orientation. So this is honestly a very good sign. And if you have a great a TCP calibration like this, you'll be able to have a great probing to define where this part is with respect to the robot base inside RoboDK. And this is the key to have a precise robot path afterwards. So thanks for watching. I hope it helps, and I'll see you in the next video.